is Cherell Brown, aka Miss Brown herself.
The piece I'm getting ready to do for you is entitled My Testimony. And the reason why I chose this piece is because it's an integral part of who I am. I began writing it last spring when I was diagnosed with a rare form of gastrointestinal cancer. Then over the summer, I had a life-changing experience. I'm not going to give you too much more detail about it. Hopefully, you'll get the gist of it through my poem. So, without further ado, my testimony. Part one. This is my introduction. The only daughter, materialization of your dreams, never wore the same size, but I inherited your genes and your nightmares because somewhere along with your eyes and nose embedded and hairy on the X chromosome was a vagrant. Set back in blackness and patience, turning me into a patient. Occasional prisoners of myself making. Turning neighbors into strangers, inscribing hieroglyphics with this printless imprints, and my body doesn't fully comprehend. And I guess this is when I stand in group and introduce myself to you. Hello, my name is Cherell, and I'm living with cancer. Living with like it's a second sign on a lease, life's lease. It only signs a second birth to me because cancer don't live here. In my eyes, and it always gets caught in sepia color pictures that my doctor's photocopy face still, I say, watch how my guy photoshops, but they not getting the bigger picture, trying to concoct the picture perfect elixir. But my medicinal faith is a prescription field. It's more like scriptural. This is my autobiography. See, I was already born a miracle child, 1988, 2 ounces shy of 2 pounds. Dr. Sims Brown, I'm sorry, but your daughter probably won't make it past the first month. 20 years later, excuse me if I just laugh, because my heart's already 841,518,380, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85 beats past last forecast, so excuse me if I'm cast out with you for seeing me, ma'am. This is my fight song, my No, I Won't Go Quiet Into the Night song, because I can't seem to wrap my head around the concept of wearing hair wraps or becoming complacent with steroids and needles punctuating my 20-year statement, so I inject steroids into even sicker words, hoping they become bigger. Bigger than this illness, transcending the blank canvas from which they came, transcending this temporary shell to dispel disbeliefs, because time only moves forward, it doesn't rewind, and even if it did, who's to say I wouldn't be on the same lifeline? So I'm kneeling to phone a friend, because there's a 50-50 chance I won't make it past my mom's 50th or my niece's first dance. But my contentment doesn't lie in hospital issues. Hospital issue linens. I grow cold and defiance before I get comfortable with dying. Part two. This is my victory speech that my God prevented for me. See, this is where my verse ends and I pass my God's pen and he precluded. I am the Lord, the God of all mankind. Is anything too hard for me? He began in reverse, erasing imperfections like accidental stray marks, putting his stamp on everything like postcards, inscribed scriptures on my DNA ribbon, so every part of me is testimony, so even in sin, I'm living holy. And it's quite comforting to know my God has humor. So he began to confuse doctors playing peekaboo with tumors. To no radiation, the only thing I'm radiating is his glory. July 22nd, 2009. Hip, this chapter remission. This is my testimony. Miss Brown herself is my pen name, and it's eclectic. I was trying to think of something that would be catchy, something that would give me stage presence, and I kept thinking and thinking as I was writing. I was like, me, myself, I'm catchy enough. So I was like, myself, herself, Miss Brown herself. So I'm just a lover of everything. I love all types of music, people, poetry, words, books. I'm just myself, and you won't put me in a mold because I won't fit. So I always strive to be in that minority. I want to give special thanks to WDX for helping me rebirth myself as a writer. I stopped writing for a significant amount of time because I got busy, or because since I was writing for funerals all the time, it became something that I associate with sadness. So if it wasn't for the group getting me back into something that I love passionately. So I thank WDX for that. And thank my boyfriend for always being supportive and there for me. Love you, Fred. And that's about it. Miss Brown herself, oh, my heart on the chain. Mad props to the God job.